Matapos itong maging virtual noong nakaraang taon dahil sa pandemya, balik in-person na sa Javits Center ang sikat na New York Comic Con. Kaya't excited din ang mga cosplayers ng iba't ibang kilalang comic books at movie characters.
Finally, you know, we're able to kind of get back to some kind of normalcy. I was very emotional walking in the first time.
Welcome to Comic-Con!
Para sa pamilyang Olaes, ang Comic-Con ay tradisyon ng puntahan ng buong mag-anak taon-taon.
So this is like Christmas for my family. This is like the most wonderful time of the year for us. We love to dress up. It's exhausting, yes, at the end of the 4 days, but we love it. But we were not overwhelmed whatsoever. In fact, it feels a lot smaller than it has been in the last few years.
Ang Phil-Am naman na si Armand Chan, dumayo pa mula sa Houston, Texas para ma-experience ang isa sa pinakamalaking comic convention sa Amerika.
You know, it's just a feeling, especially like having a chance to put yourself in the shoes of your favorite character and, you know, just seeing the joy it brings other people, you know, adults and kids alike, you know, who all want to relive their childhood.
Dito sa Artist Alley, ang Comic-Con ay pagkakataon na ipakita ng ilang Phil-Am artist ang kanilang talento sa comic art.
It's networking too.
Oh man, I would love to work for like the big studios like Walt Disney, Netflix, DreamWorks. I did like Marvel sketch cards, so I think that was like I think I practically worked for Marvel already, but yeah, I mean if they hired me to do concept art for them, I'm totally down.
I worked manual labor till I was 25, and to be able to just draw and like travel and just be free, that's my dream, and I'm pretty much doing that already.
Tampok din sa 4-day Comic-Con ang Filipino comics tulad ng Bayani at Lumpia with a Vengeance. Para sa TFC News, Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.